Arthur S. Reber, Wikipedia article audio. Arthur S. Reber is an American cognitive psychologist. He is a fellow of the American Association for the Advancement of Science, the Association for Psychological Science, and a Fulbright Fellow. He is known for introducing the concept of implicit learning and for using basic principles of evolutionary biology to show how implicit or unconscious cognitive functions differ in fundamental ways from those carried out consciously. Reber was born in Philadelphia, PA. He received his BA in 1961 from the University of Pennsylvania in psychology, working with Justin Ehrenfried and Richard Solomon, and his MA in 1965 and PhD degree in 1967 from Brown University under Richard Millward. He taught at the University of British Columbia from 1966 to 1970 when he moved to Brooklyn College and the Graduate Center of the City University of New York. In 1998 he was appointed Brooklundian Professor of Psychology. He spent 1977-78 as a Fulbright Professor at the University of Innsbruck, Austria, and 1995-96 as a visiting scholar at the University of Wales, Bangor. He retired in 2005 but maintains a visiting professor position at the University of British Columbia in Vancouver, Canada, and continues to work with colleagues and former students. Career. Research. His MS thesis was the first demonstration of implicit learning, a form of learning that takes place without awareness of either the process of acquisition or knowledge of what was actually learned. Those experiments used the artificial grammar learning methods where participants memorize strings of letters that appear chaotic but are actually formed according to complex rules. After the learning period, they are able to discern whether new, novel letter strings are grammatical or non-grammatical without being able to articulate the rules they are using. These processes have much in common with the notion of intuition, where people often find themselves able to make effective decisions without being aware of the knowledge they are using, how, or even when, they acquired it. His 1993 book, Implicit Learning and Tacit Knowledge, An Essay on the Cognitive Unconscious, reviews the early decades of research on the topic. A variety of other techniques have been developed to study implicit cognitive functions, and a host of related phenomena have been explored, including implicit memory, the implicit association test, the role of implicit acquisition in language learning and socialization, and the multinational, multi-university project Implicit. Not all agree that implicit cognitive functions invariably lie outside of awareness. Researchers such as David Shanks, Pierre Perrochet, and Lee Brooks have argued that implicit or tacit knowledge may, in fact, be available to consciousness, and that much of this tacit knowledge is not based on rules or patterns but on fragments, concrete exemplars, and instances. Reber developed a model based on the assumption that the underlying mechanisms that control implicit learning are based on evolutionarily old cortical and subcortical structures, ones that emerged long before those that modulate conscious control and self-reflection. By applying principles of evolutionary biology, the model predicts that implicit cognitive functions should display features that distinguish it from explicit functions. Specifically, implicit processes should show little individual variation compared with explicit. They should be operational early in life and continue to function as people age. They should be robust and remain intact in the face of neurological and psychiatric disorders that compromise explicit processing, and should display phylogenetic commonality. Reber maintains that human consciousness should be viewed as a pole on a continuum of subjective, phenomenal states that can be traced back to simple reactivity of organic forms and not as something special in our universe. We would do better to treat consciousness like we treat memory, not as a singular thing but as a label for a host of functions, all of which have a common functional core. Cognitive psychologists and neuroscientists are, he notes, quite comfortable viewing memory as beginning in very basic functions of cellular biology while still recognizing the various complex and sophisticated forms we see in humans as on a continuum with the primitive forms. Implicit learning. In 1985, Reber authored the Dictionary of Psychology, now in its fourth edition. His daughter Emily Reber co-authored the third edition and his wife Rhiannon Allen joined for the most recent edition. The dictionary has sold over 500,000 copies in 6 languages. In addition to his work in cognitive psychology and the philosophy of mind, Reber has had a parallel career as a reporter and commentator on gambling, particularly poker. As a freelance writer, he has authored hundreds of columns, most from the psychologist's point of view. These have been published in magazines such as Casino Player, Strictly Slots, and Poker Pro magazine, and websites like PokerListings.com. His breakdown of forms of gambling based on expected value was presented in the New Gambler's Bible. An overview of gaming appeared in Gambling for Dummies, and recently he published Poker, Life, and Other Confusing Things, a collection of essays. In 2012 he proposed a novel framework for the notion gambling based on the two dimensions of expected value of a game and the flexibility that a game affords each player. Most recently Reber has turned to novel writing. His first effort at literary fiction, 0 to 60, was published in 2015. It follows the life of Xerxes Konstantakis, a Greek layabout with intellectual roots who is tugged at constantly by the world of carnivals, smoke-filled gambling halls, poker rooms, and race tracks. We first encounter Zero when he flunks out of college and runs away with the circus and follow him through to his 60th year. Evolutionary theory. Origins of consciousness. Lexicography. A separate career. Bibliography.